14 people were shot, including a young woman who was killed, all while attending a candlelight vigil in Baytown. 25-year-old Deisha Allen lost her life while celebrating the life of a friend who had been murdered. Tonight, we are hearing from some of those who were caught in the crossfire when bullets started flying off North Market Loop and Thompson Road. And that is where KPRC2's Rowan Belogan joins us live. Rowan.
Keith, we just got new news here from of the victims. One of the three people airlifted yesterday, the family members of Elvina Moxie Thomas, says she is out of surgery after being shot in the chest yesterday, and she is expected to recover. She was here with her husband and others here yesterday when this vigil turned deadly. Walking around in a hospital gown, Dwayne Comier says it's a miracle he's able to do so.
I still got a bullet lodged in my enlarged in my shoulder. It fractured a couple of my my disc in my spine. Got a couple of fractures there, and a bullet lodged in between one of them.
Cormier is one of 13 injured at a vigil where authorities say the shooter shot into the group minutes after a balloon release. Investigators say Deisha Allen was shot and pronounced dead at the hospital.
We were first cousins, her dad and my mom, my sisters and brothers. We were first cousins. More like sisters, more like best friends, like we did everything together.
Mariah Neville says Allen leaves behind a daughter.
I'm gonna tell that to my little niece.
Harris County Sheriff's Office investigates an abandoned vehicle set on fire 2 miles from the shooting scene. Authorities say it may be the alleged shooters because it matches the make and model.
It's just awful. I mean, even just adults, I mean, it's just so dangerous, and those bullets don't have, you know, I mean, eyes or anything, and so it just puts everybody at risk.
And it was a whole bunch of little infants running around out here.
Comier says strollers and coats left behind show how hectic the night turned.
I don't know what could have sparked it because we was out here for hours. We had, I mean, everything was going smooth, nice, no problems at all.
Now, family members of these victims are begging the public, anyone with information that will lead to an arrest, to contact Harris County Sheriff's Office. Live in Baytown, Rowan Belogan, KPRC 2 News. All right.